Namaskar.
Namaskar.
Yeah, and we are back again.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, Nitin, in the last episode, we talked about Maru Bihag. And we heard a few songs. And you had said that Maru Bihag and Bihag has exactly the same notes.
Yes.
But they are very different from each other.
Yeah.
So, please tell us how they are different. What is different about
Okay.
them?
So, you know, let's begin with understanding Bihag. And then when we look at Bihag closer, you know, we'll start looking at the
right.
differences. So let's take the same route.
Okay.
Play some songs.
Right.
So, Bihag.
So, okay. So one song that I definitely know is in Bihag is from Gunjuti Shehnai. And that song is Tere Sur
Tere
Sur
Aur
Mere
Geet.
Right?
Yes.
I'm sure there are many others.
So yeah, 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 yeah. Then there is Hamare Dil Se Na Jana.
Okay.
And I think Tere Pyar Mein Dildar.
Right.
So let's listen to these songs.
Okay.
Again, you know, we'll do the same thing. Let's
right.
listen to these songs one after the other. Songs, and if you remember, you pointed out last time that normally we listen to these songs at different times, and they are also in different keys.
Right.
You know, some are male songs, some
right,
are
right.
female songs.
Yeah.
So it's very difficult to start associating them with the rag itself and start finding common phrases.
Right.
So, like last time, why don't I play them on my flute
yeah.
one after the other? And I'm sure you don't even have to, you know. Tell which song. I mean, you can make out these songs. So. So now, you know, when I play them together, one after the other, you certainly start seeing similar.
You can make out the similar phrases.
You can make out very similar phrases.
Right.
So let's look at the Bihag phrases now
right.
and, you know, look at the songs together
right.
with that.
Yeah.
This is always the beginning of Bihag. So this is the crux of it. Nisa ga maga maga risa.
So Nitin, last time you had pointed out the two madhyams.
Yeah.
And
So this is so this is where it gets different.
Right.
So if you remember, you know, we said that there are two versions of madhyam, the shuddha madhyam and the tivra.
Right.
So what is happening here is this is the shuddha madhyam, whereas so Maru Bihag had the phrase. So the basic difference is Maru Bihag was using the tivra madhyam as a prominent note, and then it was also showing the re. Re sa. Whereas in this case, so the shuddha madhyam gets prominent, and it is nisa ga ma ga, it is the shuddha madhyam, and then re is just taken fleetingly.
So re becomes shorter.
Re becomes much shorter.
Right.
Okay. And then comes the tivra madhyam, which is much shorter compared to the shuddha madhyam. So, this is Bihag.
Right.
And then you go up. So again you have Gama Pani, but again in Maru Bihag it was again Tira Madhyam prominent. So it went, in case of Maru Bihag, and it had the dha prominent.
Dha was much longer. Yeah.
Dha was much longer. In this case, we are going through the shuddha madhyam, not the tivra madhyam.
Right.
And the dha becomes much shorter. Pagamaga is the crux of Bihag.
Yeah.
So you get the same phrase. So the entire Bihag would go like.
Jasraj live singing a very popular bandish in Bihag.
Latolaji.
That
is the most popular.
Right. So Nitin, why don't you play for us a bandish in Bihar.
Bihar? Yeah, sure. This was Bihar. What next?
Right. So funnily enough, we heard Maru Bihar last time. And whenever I hear Maru Bihar, I somehow think of Kalavati.
Oh, that's an odd combination.
Yeah. And the reason for that is that there used to be an LP. Prabhatreji's LP.
Yes.
Which had Kalavati on one side and Maru Bihar on the other side. So somehow associated Maru Bihar with Kalavati.
So let's
take up Kalavati next time.
So next time we'll take Kalavati.
Okay.
Sure.